हाय स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। और ये ओके, लास्ट टाइम आई एक्सप्लेन्ड सम बेसिक पॉइंट्स इन एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर ब्रिज कोर्स, एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ मास, नंबर ऑफ आइसोटोप्स, आइसोबार्स, आइसोटोन्स, आइसोडायोफर्स ऑल कंप्लीटेड। अंड यस्टरडे आई एक्सप्लेन्ड इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ वेव हैविंग फोर इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वेव लेंथ ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी, वेव नंबर एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ लाइट आल्सो कंप्लीटेड, दैट कॉन्सेप्ट कंप्लीटेड। बेस्ड ऑन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट आई गिवन सम प्रॉब्लम्स आल्सो आई सॉल्व। सो दीज आर वेव इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज एंड प्रॉब्लम्स। नेक्स्ट अनदर वन इज टुडे फर्स्ट इन ब्रिज कोर्स बोर्स इंपॉर्टेंट फार्मूलास इन बोर्स थ्योरी एंड हाइड्रोजन Important formulas in Bohr's theory on hydrogen spectrum. Important formulas. We know. Bohr's theory already is there in intermediate, after that I will explain. Just to Bohr's theory depends on the Planck quantum theory. According to Bohr's theory, electrons revolve around the nucleus in a circular path. This path is called orbit. These are common. Orbits are represented by K, L, M, N. K means first orbit, L means second orbit, M means third orbit, N means fourth orbit. Orbit is nothing but shell. Anyone okay? But in this case, generally, in Bohr's theory, angular momentum of electron mvr equal to nh by 2 pi, that is the one other point. Angular momentum mvr equal to integral multiply of nh by 2 pi. Mvr equal to nh by 2 pi. Here n means orbit number or shell or energy level, h means strong constant, mvr means angular momentum. Angular momentum MVR equal to NH by 2 pi. Suppose angular momentum of electron in second orbit. In second orbit means simply MVR equal to NH by 2 pi, 2H by 2 pi. 2H by 2 pi means compulsory H by pi. That is a simple example. Angular momentum of electron in second orbit MVR equal to 2H by 2 pi. 2 cancel means H by pi. There will be H by pi means which orbit angular momentum? Second orbit, right? NVR into 2H by 2 pi, 2 cancel, that is okay. So these are angular momentum of electron. Okay, these are both theory on the point. Angular momentum. Next another one is very important expressions for radius of Bohr's orbit. Generally Bohr's theory explains the only one electron species. Bohr's theory can explain the one electron species. These are applicable to only hydrogen atom. Bohr's theory explains the hydrogen atom, that means one electron species only. Okay, expressions for radius of Bohr's orbit formula. Radius is r equal to n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. N square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. Here r is radius, n means orbit number, Planck constant, m means mass of electron, e means charge of electron, z means atomic number. So expressions for radius of Bohr's orbit, expression for radius of Bohr's orbit. Next, another one is These are all values are calculated. R equal to generally 0.529 n square angstrom units. These are radius of orbit in hydrogen atom. That is a radius of Bohr's orbit in hydrogen atom. In hydrogen atom. Radius of Bohr's orbit in hydrogen atom. How much value? Hydrogen atom is hydrogen contain 1 electron species. 0.529 n square angstrom. Simply R equal to 0.53 n square angstrom units. Simply. Okay, so these are radius of Bohr's orbit in hydrogen atom. Okay, so these are applicable to only 1 electron species. Suppose, okay, radius of Bohr's orbit in hydrogen atom. R equal to 0.53 n square angstrom units. Next another one is atom. Radius of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions. That means formula simply R equal to 0.529 n square by z angstrom units, or simply R equal to 0.53 n square by z angstrom units. Like hydrogen species, radius of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions, maybe 1 or 2, 3 electron species. Finally, R equal to 0.53 into n square by z angstrom units. That is a, so expressions for radius of Bohr's orbit and the radius of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions. Okay, so these are one of the important, this is one of the important points. Okay, radius of, suppose, next one is, so these are all important formulas, so don't forget remembering this. So these are radius of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions. So these are radius. Next another one is expression for energy of orbit in Bohr's, expressions for energy of orbits. Energy of orbits in hydrogen atom. Formula generally energy is E equal to minus 2 pi square me for 4 z square by n square h square. Expressions for energy of orbits in hydrogen atom. E equal to minus 2 pi square me for 4 z square by n square h square. Here except z, remaining all are constant. N is not constant. First orbit, second orbit, third. Z means atomic number. These are variable. Okay, next number is energy of orbit. In hydrogen atom, like ions, energy of orbits. In hydrogen atom, like ions is formula E equal to R calculated simply minus 2.179 into 10 to the power of minus 11 by 11 by n square into z square, that is a Higgs, that is a Higgs. Energy of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions E equal to, both are equal, so these are all values are substituted, this value will come. Energy of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions E equal to minus 2.179 into 10 to the power of minus 11 into z square by l square, that is a energy of orbit. Okay, energy of orbits in hydrogen atom like ions. These are one other point. Next, these are x and the joules also is there, energy different units. So in energy the joules, these are x. Joules means, so generally joules mean generally x joules differentiation 10 to the power of minus 7. Same E equal to minus 2.179 into 10 to the power of minus 18 by n square into z square. That is a joules. That is a one of the formula. And another one is energy E equal to another x joules completed. Next another one is minus 313.6 by n square into z square, that is a kilocalories per mole, kilocalories per mole, kilocalories per mole. And another, and another one is equal, these are all energy, all same, but expressed in different terms, different units. And minus 1312 by n square into z square by kilo joules per mole, kilo joules per mole. And another one is E equal to minus 13.6 by n square into z square, that is a electron volts, electron volts, 13.6 into z square by n square, that is a electron volts, electron volts. That is a different types of energy units. Anyway, energy of Bohr's orbit in hydrogen atom like ions. Like ions. So these are like ion means z square. In hydrogen atom, no need of z square. In hydrogen atom, no need of z square. Okay. So these are energy of orbits. Energy of orbit. And another is energy is inversely proportional to orbit. That means simple relation. Yeah, simple relation. Another one is E1 by E2 equal to N1 square, N2 square by N1 square. These are another relation. So generally, E1 by energy inversely proportional to radius of orbit. Radius of orbit increases. Radius of orbit, the size of the radius of orbit increases. So energy decreases. Anyway, E1 by E2 equal to N2 square by N1 square. So that is another relation. So don't forget, these are all our relations. Okay, next another one is one electron volts equal to 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. One electron volts equal to 1.602 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. Okay, and another one is one electron volts equal to 23.06 kilocalories, kilocalories per mole. One electron volts equal to 1.60 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Okay, these are energy of orbits in both. And another one is velocity of electron. And the velocity of electron, velocity of electron, velocity of electron in Bohr's orbit. Bohr's orbit of hydrogen atom. I am explaining only radius, energy, velocity in Bohr's orbit of hydrogen atom. Bohr's theory explains only one electron species. Velocity of electron in Bohr's orbit of hydrogen atom. Bohr's orbit of hydrogen atom. Velocity V equal to 2 pi Z e square by NH. That is a velocity of electron. Okay, velocity of electron. So these are all values are calculated. That means V equal to 2.18 into 10 to the power of 8 by N. into z, that is a centimeter per second. Centimeter per second, like hydrogen, hydrogen atom like ions, like hydrogen species, like hydrogen species. Velocity of electron v equal to 2.18 into 2.18 into 10 to the power 8 into z by n. That is a 2.88. And another is v equal to 2.88 into 10 to the power 6 by n into z meter per second. Meter per second. So that is a velocity of electron on 7. So there are 2.88 or 2.88 into 10 to the power 8. 10 to the power 8 is centimeter per second. 10 to the power 6 means meter per second. These are z. The hydrogen z known it because hydrogen atomic number 1. Okay, first orbit means 1, second orbit means 2. Velocity is inversely proportional to orbit number n. That means, so v is inversely proportional to n. That means, so v1 by v2 equal to n2 by n1. These are another relation. V1 by v2 equal to n2 by n1. That is another relation. So these are, so radius of orbit in hydrogen atom, energy of electron on orbit, and another is velocity of electron in Bohr's orbit. So these are different types of relations. Okay, so these are 2.88 into 10 to the power, so 8, 10 to the power 8 means centimeters, 10 to the power 6 means meter per second, velocity of electron. Okay, so these are velocity and energy and Bohr's orbit. Okay, next another one is maximum number of orbitals, maximum number of orbitals in any orbit. Orbit is nothing but shell. Any orbit or shell, maximum number of orbitals in any orbit equal to formula n square. Maximum number of orbitals in any orbit equal to n square. Next, maximum number of electrons in any orbit or initial equal to 2n square. So these are, orbit is nothing but shell. Orbit or shell, both are equal. Okay, so these are, here orbit is nothing but shell. Here we want orbital. What is meant by orbital? Orbitals can be defined as the probability of finding electron is maximum. The probability of finding electron is maximum is known as orbital. The probability of finding electron is maximum is known as orbital. Generally, orbitals are different types of orbitals. So s orbital, p orbital, d orbital and f orbital. S orbital is a spherical shape, non-directional orbital. P orbital is a dumbbell and a directional. So directional orbital. It is also double dumbbell. Double dumbbell, it is also directional. These are f orbital, four folded shape. These are information on it. Only non-directional and directional, it is also directional orbital. So these are s orbitals, p orbitals and d orbitals and f orbital. Generally, each orbital contains how many electrons? 2 electrons. One electron clockwise, another one is anti-clockwise. These are information in quantum numbers is there in the intermediate lesson after the direction. Now bridge course, that is a information required, basic points. Okay. Next one is SR is the spherical P apical dumbbell, D apical double dumbbell. Okay. These are non-directional, these are both are our directional orbitals. Next one is generally in P subshell. In a P subshell, the three orbitals are represented as Px, Py, and Pz. Generally, P subshell division. P subshell containing how many orbitals are represented in 3? Px, Py, Pz orbitals. Px, Py, and Pz orbitals. You know generally Px orbital is like that. So these are your x axis, y axis, z axis. Your x, your y, your z. Here also x, y, z. Your Px orbital is like that. X, R, P, Y, R, P, Z, R, P, Z, R, P, X, R, P, Y, R, P, Z. Okay. P, X, P, Y, P, Z are class. So, in a P subshell, the three orbitals are represented as P, X, P, Y, P, Z orbitals. Okay. P subshell contains total number of electrons, how many? 6. Because each orbital 2 electrons. Each orbital containing 2 electrons. Here 2 electrons, 2 electrons, 2 electrons. Anyway, P subshell contains how many electrons? 6 electrons. P orbital is considered as orbital means one box. Okay. P orbital containing 2 electrons. P subshell contains how many electrons? 6 electrons. And the other one is PXO, PY, PZ orbitals. PZ orbitals. PXO, PY, PZ orbitals are generally axis in between. So Px, Py, Pz orbitals are oriented, axis oriented in between the axis, in between the axis. That means Px, Py, Pz orbitals, Px, Py, Pz orbitals are oriented in between the axis. PXO, PY, PZ orbitals are oriented in between the axis. Okay, so these are PXO, PY, PZ orbitals. And the other one is degenerate orbitals. So what do you mean by degenerate orbitals? Orbitals having same energy levels are called degenerate orbitals. Orbitals having same energy levels are called degenerate orbitals. Example, P orbitals and D orbitals. P orbitals and D orbitals having same energy level. Now I am taking P orbitals. These are. Okay. First orbital, so they are Px. One side. These are P subshell containing Px, Py, Pz. So these are same energy level. Px, how much energy is there? Py also. Py, how much energy is there? Pz also. PXO, PY, PZ, these are P subshell. Orbitals having same energy level are called degenerate orbitals. Example, degenerate orbitals. Example, degenerate orbitals. Example, P orbitals, D orbitals. I mean P subshell and D subshells. Okay, these are P orbitals. And in a D subshell, next to. In a D subshell, the five orbitals are represented as DXY, DYZ, DZX, DX square minus Y square and DZ square. Okay, dx square minus y square, dz square. Here, dxy, dyz, g, B ZX or orbitals are oriented along the axis. DXY, DYZ, DZX orbitals are oriented along their axis. But DX square minus Y square, DZ square orbitals are oriented in between the axis. Now I will give DXY like that. DXY means these are X, these are Y, like that. DXY. Next, DYZ. DYZ means YZ. That means DYZ. DZX. DYZ, DXY, DYZ, DXY, DXY, DYZ, DZX. Next, DX square minus Y square. X square minus Y square is like that. Next up. DZ square. Generally, DXY, DYZ, DZX orbitals are oriented in between the axis. But DX square minus Y square and DZ square orbitals are oriented along their axis. That is, in any way, D orbitals in a D subshell, the five D orbitals are represented. The five d orbitals are represented as dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. These are orbitals. Okay, orbital can be defined as the probability of finding electron is maximum is known as orbital. So that is a orbital information. Next, what is meant by electronic configuration? Electronic configuration means the systematic arrangement of electrons. So, electronic configuration. The systematic arrangement of electrons in atomic orbitals is known as electronic configuration. The systematic arrangement of electrons in atomic orbitals is known as electronic configuration. That is a electronic configuration. These are orbitals, so energy levels order. First, S orbital grad less than P, D and F orbital. Order of energies. Order of energies of orbitals. S, P, D, F. Okay, we know systematic arrangement of electrons in atomic orbitals is known as electronic configuration. We know electronic configuration means, for example, so oxygen is there, atomic number 8, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. These are depends on the n plus l value means they are quantum numbers. Next concept, okay, in intermediate lesson we will explain. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Compared to yes, p energy levels are more. Next another is sodium is there. Sodium 11, that means 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, after that which one is 3s1. So these are one of the Moiré diagram, simply like that. these are Yarnam. Next, anomalous. Anomalous electronic. Anomalous electronic configuration. Anomalous electronic configuration of element. Electron configuration of elements water. Electron configuration of elements water. Anomalous electron configuration. First, chromium and copper. Chromium 24. So that means simply 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Actually, 4s1 and 3d5. Actually, 4s2, 3d, 4s2, 3d4. But actually, d electrons having half period or complete period more stable. That for one electron goes to here, that means losing electron 4s1, 3d5. And copper 29, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d10. Okay, so these are anomalous electron configuration of element. These are chromium and copper. Okay, these are next. Isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species means species having equal number of electrons. Here species means cations are, anions are, molecules also. Okay. So species having. Species having. Here species means atoms, molecules or ions. Atoms, molecules or ions. Species having equal number of electrons. Species having equal number of electrons are called isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species. Example, Na plus, Mg2 plus, Al3 plus. These are cation species. These are cations. Na plus, how many electrons here? 10 electrons. Here 10 electrons. Here 10 electrons. Equal number of electrons. That is a example one. Isoelectronic species. Species having species, atoms or molecules or ions. Species having equal number of electrons are called isoelectronic species. Okay. Next number is Example 2, N3 minus, O2 minus, F minus, these are anions. Here how many electrons? 10 electrons. Nitrogen 10, 7, gaining of 3 electrons. Here 8, 2 electrons gain, 10. Here 9, gaining of 1 electron, 10 electrons. These are all isoelectronic species of cations and anions. And another is molecules. Example 3, molecules means nitrogen, carbon monoxide. Nitrogen, how many electrons? 14, 7 plus 7, 14 electrons. So carbon monoxide, 14 electrons. So these are our molecules. Molecules. Okay, these are isoelectronic species. And another example 4, carbon dioxide and N2O, N2O laughing at. The carbon dioxide, carbon 6, 1 oxygen 8. 8 plus 8 16, 16 plus 16, 16 plus 6, 22 electrons. Here 22 electrons is there, here 22 electrons. Here nitrogen 7, 7 plus 7 14, 14 plus 8 22, here also 22 electrons. So these are also isoelectronic species. Species having equal number of electrons are called. Species means here molecules are ions, atoms not coming. Okay, main atoms or ions or molecules. These are isoelectronic species. Isoelectronic species. So these are important points. Next up.
Next answer is O. Next answer is O. Ferrous. Next answer is ferrous. Ferrous means Fe2+. And ferric. Ferric means Fe3+. Ferrous. That means Fe2+, ferric 3+. So ferrous, these are ferrous, ferric. Among ferrous and ferric, which one is more stable? Ferric is more stable. Ferric is more stable because now I will give you configuration Fe2+. That means argon. Actually iron. Before actually iron is 26. So configuration of argon 4s2. 3d6. Okay. Fe2+ means 2 electrons losing. 2 electrons losing means here losing. That means Fe2+ means argon 4s0 3d6. Ferrous. Ferric means 3 electrons losing. That means argon. 3 electrons is losing. First 4s electrons. So after that 3d electron. First 4s energy level less. These are losing 2 electrons. After that this electron. That means 4s0 3d5. Who know? D electrons having half fluid or completely fluid. D orbital in degenerate orbitals, p orbitals and d orbitals, so half fluid or completely fluid orbitals so having more and more stability. Then 3d6 and 3d5, which one is more stable? 3d5 more stable because of half fluid configuration. Then so it is a more stable, more stable. Anyway, ferrous and ferric, which one is more stable? Ferric is more stable than ferrous because of half filled D substrate D. Okay, half filled D orbital. Okay, so these are ferrous, ferric. These are examples. Ferrous means Fe2+, ferric means Fe3+. So these are all different types of some important formulas. And another one is radius of orbits, energy levels, velocity of electron. And another one is orbitals. And another one is ferrous, ferric ions, and another one is isoelectronic species. So these are some important basic points in the today concept. Remaining points tomorrow I will explain. Remaining concept tomorrow I will explain. Okay, dear students, thank you for all. Okay.